Mary Magdalene stood crying outside the tomb. She was still weeping when she stooped down and saw two angels inside. They were dressed in white and were sitting where Jesus' body had been. One was at the head and the other was at the foot. The angels asked Mary, "Why are you crying?" She answered, "They have taken away my Lord's body. I don't know where they have put him." As soon as Mary said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there. But she did not know who he was. Jesus asked her, "Why are you crying? Who are you looking for?" She thought he was the gardener and said, "Sir, if you have taken his body away, please tell me so I can go and get him." Then Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him, "Rabboni." The Aramaic word Rabboni means teacher. Jesus told her, "Don't hold on to me. I have not yet gone to the Father, but tell my disciples I am going to the one who is my Father and my God, as well as your Father and your God." Those words come from John chapter 20, verses 11 to 17. When Jesus was crucified, the soldiers gambled for his clothes. On the resurrection morning, the grave clothes were left in the tomb. So where did Jesus get the clothes he was wearing when he met Mary in the garden, and she thought that Jesus may have been the gardener? Well, the Bible does not give us the answer to that question specifically, but we know that God provided the clothes that Jesus needed when he came out of the tomb. In the book of Genesis, we read the story of the first Adam and how God made clothes for Adam and Eve. So here is the story of the second Adam, and God clothed him as well. The lesson for me is simple and yet profound. When I am born again, and when I rise to walk after coming out of the watery grave of baptism, God gives me new clothes. My new clothes are amazing, to say the least. God covers my shame with the righteousness of Christ. When Joseph was exalted from the prison to second in command in Egypt, I cannot imagine that he brought any of his prison clothes to that palace. A temptation for many Christians is to continue to wear the clothes from your old life. The righteousness of Jesus is a whole new wardrobe, and you don't need to hold on to your old clothes. Clean out your closet and dress only in the righteousness of Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, thank you for covering me with your righteousness. Thank you for giving me the clothes that make me look like you to those who see me each day. And may you be praised forever. Amen.